wildfires of 2011 were some of the worst disasters in Texas history. In that year, over 30,000 wildland fires consumed roughly 4 million acres and destroyed nearly 3,000 homes throughout the state. In a dry climate such as ours, and especially on windy days, wildfires can strike at any moment. But there are steps we can take to protect property and save lives. In this series of videos, we will look at the four steps that are essential to combating wildfires. They are prevention.
Most fires are started by humans, and it's caused carelessness or things that are preventable and they just don't think about.
Preparedness.
We should always be prepared just in case a wildfire does start and approach our property.
Response.
Fighting a wildfire, fighting any fire in any brush is an extreme challenge.
And recovery.
Neighbors were helping neighbors the best that they could. First responders were on the scene.
Travis County first responders are no stranger to fighting wildfires. But in September of 2011, a perfect storm of fires occurred. The sheer number and size of these fires created challenges that few, if any, of the firefighters had ever faced.
On September 4, 2011, Central Texas and much of the rest of the state of Texas was in one of the worst droughts ever recorded. We were getting wind gusts of 30 to 40 miles an hour that any fire that got started we knew would be hard to control. Well, that morning about between 10 and 11 o'clock, one of the northeast Travis County districts had a fire. After that, they had two more fires within that area. While they were still fighting the three fires up in the Pflugerville area, the Perdinalis fire started, and then shortly thereafter, the Steiner Ranch fire.
Fighting a wildfire, fighting any fire in any brush, whether it's in the grassland or it's in the forested areas, is an extreme challenge. As opposed to a structure fire, that structure fire is in place, we know where it is, it's going to be right there in front of us. You get a fire out in the wildland, it's going to take off and run on you, and run in all different directions.
The other challenge is that today's wildfires are no longer just in pure wild land, but also in more populated areas referred to as wildland-urban interfaces.
The wildland-urban interface, or the WUI, it's not a place, it's a set of conditions. If people are living in an area that is also has enough vegetation to sustain a wildfire, then that's WUI, that's a wildland-urban interface. You talk to any wildland firefighter, they'll tell you that they fought thousands of acres prior and never saw a house, and now they see several homes. Now there's whole communities built out in the woods. It creates a unique environment for firefighting because you can't use traditional home fire, residential fire techniques. The big trucks, they can't survive. We don't have enough water to put those kinds of things out, and then it stretches resources thin.
After fires on western Travis County broke out, and then the Bastrop complex, not only were local resources drained, but resources all over Texas became very scarce. And in fact, on one of the fires that I was in charge of in our district, I requested additional brush trucks. There were none available in the area.
Immediately after we got into the second fire, we called for, we being Travis County, requested state firefighting resources. We were told everything had been sent to other fires. And so as we began to understand later on, there were fires throughout the state of Texas.
The sheer size of wildfires, the unpredictability, the inability to see their path on the ground, all make for a much more dangerous situation for firefighters.
We actually injure more firefighters in the wildland than we do in the structural firefighting because the situation changes moment to moment. And certainly as fire takes off across country, having a visualization of what's going on is an extreme challenge.
Enter Starflight, Travis County's helicopter service, traditionally used in emergency medical transport as well as search and rescue. But Starflight has also proven effective in fighting wildfires.
One of the real advantages from Starflight is that we're here, we're available 24 hours a day. And normally within getting the call, within 10 minutes, the crew is airborne and en route to a fire.
Not every county in Texas, and certainly only a few, have the ability to do aerial reconnaissance over fire. And that's a huge, huge advantage that we have. If we can literally put eyes in the sky early on, then we can assess and make an attack plan based on what we see early on.
A lot of times we'll pick up one of the chiefs or whoever is acting as a commander on scene and take them around, let them get an aerial view of what's going on.
Many times just an airborne view of the fire really helps the incident commander figure out where to deploy their resources, how to access a fire. And so a lot of times the helicopter just gives you great mobility.
When physical transport of a ground commander is not possible, information technology plays a helpful role.
We got technology that allows us to do mapping of fires. So it gives us a size of the fire. We can also take video and photos from the air, and we can email those to the ground fire commander so that they can actually see what the fire is doing, where it's headed, and its behavior.
But of course, Starflight crews do more than just spot the fires. They often help the ground crews put them out.
We can put the Bambi bucket on and start actually dropping water. The Bambi bucket is an orange bucket that hangs beneath the helicopter. It attaches to our cargo hook, which is designed for lifting. We normally fly around with about 130 gallons of water, and then it's pilot controlled. Once you're over the scene, they can push a button and it can drop the water that's in the bucket. As opposed to the more dedicated firefighting helicopter can carry 320 gallons of water, and it does it with a fixed tank that's bolted to the aircraft. So for flying around in an urban environment, it's a little safer because you don't have to worry about it coming off of the cargo hook like you do the Bambi bucket, and it gives us a little bit more flexibility.
While fighting any fire in the wildlands, water sources can certainly be a challenge.
Normally we would get water out of stock tanks, ponds, things like that. Well, as the drought continued, those dried up. The other thing that with the stock tanks was the farmers and ranchers, understandably so, you know, we're getting upset about, you know, taking the water that they needed for their livestock. So one of the things that we did was acquired our pumpkin. It's a 4,800 gallon tank and it's designed to dip out of. So it really allowed us to have a reliable water source close to the fire without impacting, the area farmers and ranchers.
While the fire departments and Starflight are putting out the fires, they receive a lot of help from other county departments. For example, the road and bridge crews of the Transportation and Natural Resources Department clear paths for the firefighters to work.
We have a group of employees that are actually trained in wildfire response, which means they're trained to use the heavy equipment to assist fire departments in cutting fire breaks via bulldozers, motor graders, that sort of type of equipment that's not usually available to them.
Law enforcement also has a role in wildfire response.
Well, our primary responsibility is the notification and evacuation of the citizens. Once we have enough resources in place, then we set up our traffic control. During the Steiner and Spicewood fires, some of the problems that we had was citizens trying to sneak back into the perimeter of the fire locations to check on their property, try to get items out of their houses and that sort of thing. That was really the main problems that we saw outside of course, trying to contain the fires. It's a safety issue, number one, because they don't have the information that we're receiving, the direction of the fire or any other hazardous activities that are going on, and it causes us to divert our resources.
Of course, even in a support role, the sheriff's office doesn't act alone.
We coordinate very closely with the fire departments and respond to the needs that they need us to perform. Fire is really good about establishing command posts at every incident. Usually in the command post, you have every discipline, fire, EMS, and law enforcement together, and you have a much quicker flow of communication.
How many resources do you have committed and how many are remaining in the city?
Communication and coordination are vital in the fight against wildfire. While field command posts handle these tasks very well, the Emergency Operations Center, located in the Austin-Travis County CTEC facility, makes this coordination all the more efficient.
CTEC stands for the Combined Transportation, Emergency, and Communications Center. Our partners are the City of Austin, Travis County, Capital Metro, and the Texas Department of Transportation. So the building itself is founded on a partnership. The Emergency Operations Center is founded on a partnership that's even larger than that. We have all of the first responder public safety agencies, our public transportation folks, our private transportation folks, our health and medical, hospitals. Whatever we need to support an event is who we call in. And people have found that it's so much easier to address a problem in a group than it is trying to address it individually.
Cooperation from many different entities saves lives and property. But officials alone can't fight fires. It takes an entire community effort. So in what ways can residents help first responders?
When you see or hear a fire truck coming, you're supposed to move to the right, stop, and yield the right of way. And I can't reinforce that enough.
A defensible space is the idea that you're giving a buffer zone in which firefighters can work.
Of course, it would be best if the fire never existed at all.
Prevention is the key. You know, if we can prevent the fire from ever occurring, then, you know, that minimizes the need for the fire department or the helicopter to begin with.
Find out more about wildfire safety in the Ready, Set, Go brochure, available at TravisCountyTX.gov/wildfire.